college football's winningest coaches, Pat Dye of Auburn and Fred Akers of Texas, tonight face a rematch of a key game of 1983. A year ago, it was Akers' Longhorns that prevailed and went on to an undefeated regular season. This 80-yard pass from Rick McIver to Kelvin Epps clinched it for third-ranked Texas, knocking Auburn out of second spot in the nation. Epps is back again, and the Tigers have a big play man of their own with Heisman Trophy candidate Bo Jackson, who scored 12 touchdowns in 1983, including this 80-yard jaunt versus Florida. Jackson carries the hopes of Auburn tonight, and if Texas is to make it two in a row, the Horns will probably have to go to the air again. Stadium in Austin, Texas. A capacity crowd here as we near kickoff. Auburn has won the toss and they will receive. So we'll see the wishbone formation of Pat Dye first in action. And the question is, can Auburn bounce back after its disheartening loss to Miami to open the season? There he is, Pat Dye, in his 11th year, won 79, lost only 33, and tied one. Winningest coach that they've had percentage wise for a while at Auburn University. Kicking off for Texas will be Jeff Ward. There's Fred Akers, his 10th year. He's set the all-time percentage winning mark in the Southwest Conference, winning almost 80% of his games, has won over 80% of his conference games. Here's Jeff Ward, a sophomore from Austin, before the home crowd. He'll kick off. He's the kicking specialist. And by the way, Texas has one of the great kicking games in college football. And number 22, Brent Fullwood, a sophomore, will run back the kickoff. That means he's in there where we usually see Bo Jackson.
Well, and this is also a young man, Jim, that they feel that may be better than Bo Jackson.
Well, he's certainly exciting and explosive from St. Cloud, Florida. 196, and he can fly, and we're underway. Low bounding kick, and it'll get back to Fullwood at the 2. Tries it up the middle of the 20 to the 23-yard line, and he's stopped right there by Texas. And now for Auburn. They'll come in with Pat Washington, number 10, a quarterback, a junior. They expect him to go the air for the possession passes here tonight. He'll run the wishbone. Fullback is Tommy Agee, a key man. Bo Jackson will start at right halfback. Kyle Collins is the left half, a junior. And the wide receiver is Trey Gaines. Tight end Jeff Parks. And here we go with the first play of the game from Austin, Texas. Auburn first and 10. Back at his own 23. And this is Bo Jackson. Flies the left side, stopped by Ralph Darnell. Darnell's the right tackle, along with Tony DeGreat. The ends are Bronner and James McKinney. The middle linebacker's Tony Edwards, who's in for an assist on that play. Number 63, who's 260 pounds. The outside linebackers are Ty Allard and June James, and they're fine ones. And joining Jerry Gray in the backfield, Tony Griffin, Stephen Braggs, and James Lott. So that's the defensive assignment as Bo Jackson has carried the ball for the first time. It's second down and 6. They take the fullback. The option, they take the quarterback down. A great play by James McKinney, the left hand of Texas. Oh, they may stop that option pitch with this type of play.
All right, but let's take a look, first of all, at Bo Jackson. Now, watch this. You think they're after Gray. We said they're going to try to put Gray on the ground. That they did. But as you said, James McKinney, number 87, just went right after the quarterback, Washington, and there's a loss on the play.
And it's third down 11, and Brady Wagan, a great young freshman receiver, is in. Here's Washington, the play action. Drills it, and it is caught over there by Jeff Parks, the tight end. Stephen Braggs is right there. It's way short of the first down. And Auburn will have to put the ball away.
You're seeing one example right now of an inexperienced passing team. Now, Parks went down, number 82. He's the tight end. He goes down for the pass, but he doesn't get enough for the first down, Jim.
Back into safety, Kelvin Epps, wide receiver, senior from Dallas, number 5, Lewis Colbert. Quite a heartwarming story, born with a club foot, but an outstanding punter for Auburn. He'll kick him about his own 20. Here's the kick against the wind. Fair catch called to the up back, and it is taken there by Felt. And Texas will have great field position here early in the first quarter from Austin, Texas. No score. Auburn versus Texas.
Lewis Colbert, he get a 17-yard putt here, but you must, when you're kicking into the wind, keep the ball as close to the ground as possible. You cannot let it get up in the air, and as soon as he hit it, you saw the ball go straight up in the air, go 17 yards, and wind caught it.
The second time, Texas now takes over its own 45, and here's the play-action fake. Dodge over the middle, a wobbly pass thrown incomplete, trying to hit Harris. Coming across over the middle from tight end, and Kevin Green was back to put the heat on Dodge, along with Harold Holloman. So pretty good pressure that time, but not a good thrown pass at all.
It wasn't a good thrown pass because the ball is going to go up in the air. This is William Harris coming across. Now watch how high the ball is. First of all, he gets knocked off, but the ball is way too high. No chance at all. And also McCurdy back there again, 52. He's covering a lot of ground.
Well, Peebo getting a little anxious here. Texas not able to cash in on his good field position. Here's a play-action rollout. Dodge got a man open. Harris, the tight end. Inside the 40 to the 37. Matt Caesar makes the stop. And William Harris is becoming the number one target for Todd Dodge, who's gone to the air.
Yeah, but we got to watch what Todd Dodge does now. Watch. He's going to go out on a rollout. There is the fake to Robinson in the backfield. Now he sets himself up. You see where you set? You have to do that when you're throwing that pass. When you're rolling to your left and you're a right-handed passer. Now here's Harris. Look at how wide open he is. He's in the secondary. Caesar, number 49, playing the safety spot, the free safety spot, never got there.
Kevin Elps and Brett Duhon, the wide receivers. Remember, Elps pulled an 80-yarder last year against Auburn. Here's Dodge going to the sidelines to Elps over his head out of bounds. He was pretty well covered down there by David King. Robinson had gone in to put a great rush on Dodge. William Harris was also out there, but it'll be an incomplete pass and second down 10 for Texas.
That's a true sideline when you knock a cameraman down.
Yeah. Just saw what Dodge did last year. He's probably the best pure passer Texas had. He's not a depth runner at all. He's strictly a passer. Had a great record in high school at Port Arthur, where he teamed up with his now teammate Brent Duhon, a wide receiver.
And we're seeing what we talked about at the beginning, the intermediate routes, anywhere from 12 to, I'll give him, to 20 yards, not much deeper.
Bill Boy Bryant's in there. He's a clutch catcher, wide receiver. Pitch it back to Robinson, tries the sweep. No, Auburn's right there to slam the door in the person of Kevin Green, 238-pound senior in from Anniston, Alabama, a walk-on for Pat Dye, and he was Johnny on the spot there along with number 96, John Daly.
Well, Green played it so well on the outside. I mean, there's just no place to go. And when you play the defensive end that well, you better grab your socks.
So it's still 10 yards to go on third down for Texas. They're stalled again here at this time the 38-yard line of Auburn. And Dodge on the play-action fake rolling. He fires, got a man open. He hits him down here out of the backfield, Johnson. Johnson's got the first down. He's inside the 20. Texas with an explosive passing attack here. Suddenly on third down, connects. Todd Dodge to Jerome Johnson, and it clicks.
You know, you can have all the time in the world, but when you have a back coming out there like Johnson, Jerome Johnson, number 35. Now look at Todd Dodge. He's going towards, he squares his body upfield when he throws the pass. Jerome Johnson is there for the catch. But again, a breakdown in the defensive secondary. No one on Johnson.
Well, the rollout also takes away a lot of the effectiveness of the rush.
It really does. It confines the defensive lineman to the inside, and the only man that really gets a good rush would be the outside end or linebacker if he splits it.
Now first and 10 from the Auburn 19. Brett developing here for Texas. They give it a tailback. Robinson breaks a tackle. Hits it to the 10 and inside. Almost a 10-yard powerful run by Ronnie Robinson, a senior from Dallas. Came in here with a hip pointer, but he's playing well.
Fullback converted to tailback, but watch his continuous effort. Watch his legs. His legs never stop moving. Gets his feet back underneath him and back to the outside. He picks up about 9 yards, I guess. They're going to measure this thing, almost a first down. But that's just a continuous effort, keeping your legs moving.
Here's the measurement. The referee, by the way, is Joe Thomas. The umpire, Jack Smalley. Linesman, Buddy Coleman. Line judge, Robert Caldwell. If he makes it, it'll be first and goal. Just missed it. Going to be second and inches. Field judge is Ron Underwood, and the back judge is Bobby Skelton. But Texas now threatening to open the scoring here in the first quarter. 6 minutes, 48 seconds to go. Texas has never lost an opening game under Akers. As a matter of fact, they have a great record overall in opening games. They've lost only 9 of them in 91 years.
The one thing that Texas prides himself, first of all, defense. They stopped Auburn the first two times Auburn had the ball. The other thing is special teams, Jim. They figure the special teams with the turnovers will help their team get him in good field position. but they didn't really do anything on special teams except the punter for Auburn. Colbert had a 17-yard punt and a 25-yard punt and gave him great field position.
Great story for Dodge. He was supposed to start last year against Auburn, got a shoulder injury, and had to be sidelined. Here he is trying to take Texas in. They hit up the middle of Robinson, and he is crunched hard by that Auburn line. Greg Carr, the All-American linebacker, and Nate Hill, their sensational freshman from LaGrange, Georgia, teamed up to make the stop.
It's going to be third down. He doesn't make it. Here goes Robinson, and he's following Johnson up into the hole. But watch this. Here is the hit coming down the line. Greg Carr was in there, but the hit was made on the outside by number 42. Is that Kelly, I think?
Now they send in two tight ends, Texas does, William Harris and Joe Monroe. They also bring in Terry Orr, another fullback for blocking. Texas going to line up with a full house backfield, a power eye, and double tight end try to get this first down. Look for Robinson. Yep, it's Robinson. No, he's thrown for a loss at the 10. What a gallant defensive series for Auburn. They've stopped Texas twice now and thrown them for a loss on that play. Gerald Williams, a junior, came up with that one, Finn Thomas.
Gerald Williams, Robinson 95, Williams is number 98. Just watch the surge of the defensive line. When you beat the offensive lineman to the punch, there's just no place to go. That time it was played beautifully.
Remember, it was second down and just inches to go. It's fourth and a yard coming up here with the score. Auburn nothing, Texas nothing. And we'll be right back. Here on fourth and one at the Auburn 10. He has sent three fullbacks in his lineup. Jerome Johnson, Terry Orr, and Ronnie Robinson with Todd Dodge.
Agree with the call?
That's not a bad call. Certainly probably could get three, but maybe he's expecting some scoring.
You always put points on the board when you can.
Orr in motion. And here comes Dodge on the bootleg roll out. He's going to get the first down. Todd Dodge making a touchdown. He does. Touchdown, Texas. It was a naked rollout, but a great fake. Well, nothing surprises like surprise.
That was a beautiful call, Jim. And what happens when a linebacker commits himself, and I think it was Greg Carr, number 54, you must stay at home because you're not going to help anything on the other side of the field.
And remember the book on Todd Dodge is he can't run.
Someone forgot to tell Todd Dodge that.
And the try for the point after Jeff Ward. And he's 32 in a row without a miss is Jeff Ward. The sophomore from Austin has never missed a point after. Let's take a look again at this bootleg rollout by Dodge. Very few blockers in front of him.
All right, watch number 72. He's going to block down. Number 78, Stewart, pulls to the left. Now, Todd Dodge has the ball coming this way. All the action goes left, the right of Auburn. And here comes Dodge back to the outside. Really, nobody there. Robinson, Gerald Robinson, number 95, was there. Carr did not stay at home where he should have stayed. And there's a touchdown.
I'm a commissioner.
A happy young man there. Todd Dodge just scored his first touchdown of the season, and Texas leads 7-0. Back deep now will be Brent Fullwood for Auburn. And here's Ward with another bounding kick. They respect the speed of Auburn. This one's going to go through the end zone. We'll come out to the 20. The new rule does not affect that ball. It has to carry beyond the end line on the fly to come to the 30. This will be first and 10, Auburn at the 20-yard line.
Well, there's the drive. 9 plays, 55 yards, 328, and then Dodge on the run. But see, this penalizes a kicker, Jeff Ward, with that rule. Because with the wind at his back, Jeff Ward can kick the ball out of this end zone. But if he does, the ball comes out to the 30-yard line.
Now Auburn in their eye. Here's a pitch to Bo Jackson. Spilled up back there. Fine low tackle by Stephen Braggs, a strong safety. And Paul, Texas is throwing everybody up here to put pressure against Auburn's run.
And I'll tell you one thing. If Braggs doesn't make this play, Bo Jackson is gone. Bo Jackson, now watch this. He's going to cut back to the outside. Watch where Braggs catches him with his feet. He just whips out. Bo Jackson's feet slip out from underneath him. If he'd have gotten around there, you don't see it on the replay, but there's no one out there.
Bo Jackson runs the 100 in about 9.4. That's how he can fly. It's like a fumble, and Washington drops on it. He escaped a little disaster right there for Auburn. Texas leads 7-0. And Auburn having a little trouble getting on track here offensively in the first quarter of the game. A ball will be spotted at the 17-yard line. It'll be third down, about 13 to go. James Lott comes in replacing Eric Jeffries in the backfield for Texas. Akers a little anxious about his young defensive players back there. Trying to get a lot of pressure with his lineman on the pass. We're not giving him enough time. The passing situation here for Washington. Washington sack. It was DeGreat. Tony DeGreat was in there and dropped Washington like a freight train. And he goes down inside the 10-yard line. And Texas is really fired up.
Well, Tony DeGreat, he runs over Floyd, number 63, the tackle. But this is Tony DeGreat at his best, and you want to watch Washington disappear. Now, he's gone. There's DeGreat. Floyd, number 63, is on the ground.
Well, small wonder, number 99 is a candidate for national honors. A little bobble there by Colbert. He gets it away. Wynn catches it again. And here's going to be the catch taken about the 45-yard line. And the run back by Calvin Epps only about a yard or so. ESPN is proud to announce its association with the Chevrolet Scholarship Program. ESPN sports commentators will be selecting a Chevrolet Most Valuable Player from each team as part of every 1984 college football telecast. Chevrolet then honors those selections by donating $1,000 to each college general scholarship fund that'll help advance the education of deserving students. It's the beginning of this program's 14th year, and here at ESPN, we're very proud to be participating. This is in Auburn territory at the 44. The wind's been a very big factor here in the first quarter. And here's a give on the inside. They try to fool him with a fake on the pitch out. And Rob Morshall now is in the backfield. But that ball went to the fullback, Terry Orr. And Greg Carr met it at the line of scrimmage. A little welcoming committee that Orr's not going to forget for a minute or two. He really rocked it.
Yeah, he sure did. Bob Morshall. Now, remember, this man was a quarterback.
Matter of fact, he was a starting quarterback until about a week ago.
Yeah, well, now he's a halfback, but he does have a bad back. But don't be surprised to see the old pitch and the pass.
That could be a halfback pass. Morshall, who's scheduled to be the starting quarterback, now running a tailback. Another rollout, play action fake. They throw it back to Morshall. Off of the screen pass inside the 40. And he's going to be stopped way short of the first down by Ben McCurdy, weak side linebacker. Texas has not been bashful at all about reaching down the bag of tricks here tonight. They have played wide open football against Auburn, which shows great respect for Auburn's defense. Texas likes to set up and just run straight at you and realizes Auburn's got an outstanding team. They've had to mix in a lot more. The wind, no doubt, has had a better force here in the first quarter of this game. It's kept Texas in great field position. Morshall has come out of there. Tailback is Orr at the only setback. Here's the quick one over the middle of Bill Boy Bryant. Bill Boy Bryant looking for open field. 20, 15, cutting back. Bill Boy Bryant to the 10. And down on the 7-yard line, spectacular run by colorful Bill Boy Bryant.
Well, when you see Bill Boy Bryant, you're going to see when they throw the ball out here, Dodge throws it, he sees him, he reads the defense, look it, no one is near him. That's Beasley, number 31. Now, Bill Boy is going to make a lot of cuts and a lot of moves, it excites the crowd, but he's going to make one last cut that he wished he didn't make because Nate Hill, number 99, is going to make him disappear right about now. Goodbye.
Nate Hill's a 265-pound freshman tackle from LaGrange, Georgia. They think he's going to be a great All-American now. There's Bill Boy Bryant. That's his real name, Bill Boy. He's a clutch player, a high school quarterback. He's set a lot of records down in Dublin, Texas. And here he is, a senior. He's going to join the PGA Tour someday, he hopes, an outstanding golfer. North Carolina versus Boston College will be coming to you from Foxborough next Saturday, September 22nd, 7:30 Eastern Time. That'll be Doug Flutie, who's a good candidate for the Heisman Trophy against North Carolina. A team that was surprised today but showed a lot of scoring punts. Then Navy versus Arkansas on September the 29th from Little Rock. Those are the next two games coming up on Saturday Night Football from the CFA, the College Football Association, the most exciting brand of football being played and one of the most exciting sports in the world. Don't you agree?
I agree.
Texas leads here. There's the record we told you. They lost only 9 times in 91 years in opening games. Fred Akers has never lost an opening game here at home. Matter of fact, Texas has won 8 in a row, an opening game, and they lead 7-0 here over Auburn, but we're early in the game. They're threatening again. First and goal. Ball at the 7-yard line. They got another full-house backfield here. The handoff is to Orr, tries to duck inside, and there's nothing there. Thought he saw a crack, but it was closed up very quickly. Pat Thomas looked like the first man that got to him, number 41. Auburn's defense has been backed up the entire first quarter. It started when they were unable to get a first down in the first series, and then the wind played havoc with the Auburn punting. Texas moved down, tried a field goal, didn't miss. Looked like Auburn would get a break. They still couldn't move against the Texas defense. The next time, the Longhorns took it in, and here they are back once more. Double tight end, Harrison Monroe. Tailback is Robinson. They give it to Orr again. Blockers in front of him. Cuts back, and he is to the goal line, but I don't think he got it over. Terry Orr, a senior from Abilene, has been plagued by injury, but he's been a key man already here for Texas in the first quarter. 1 minute, 25 seconds to go in the quarter, and Texas leads 7-0, and they're threatening to make it more. There's what Terry did last year. Not bad. He was one of the all-time high school players down here in Texas a few years ago, and he's had a lot of injuries here. But tonight, looks like he's ready for a big season in 1984. Michael Brown now has gone in, replacing Ronnie Robinson. Brown is a senior from Dallas.
They're getting everybody in the game, aren't they?
Third down, they got less than a yard to go for a touchdown. They give it over the middle to Orr. Oh, no, it's Brown. Michael Brown, touchdown for Texas. Well, it was Terry Orr. Orr, who dives over the middle, gets the touchdown.
Well, look at all the action. Watch the offensive line. They must get off, which they did right there. And you see Orr go up over the top. Remember, only the ball has to break the plane. The ball did that. Both officials at the same time have the touchdown.
So Texas has scored twice in the first quarter. 50 seconds to go. Ward's in to try for his 33rd straight point after touchdown. He's got it. Almost automatic, and Smokey the Cannon is already in action here in Austin tonight. As we come down the final minute of the first quarter, Texas goes up 14-0.
Well, I watched the line play, first of all. They get the defensive lineman all down. When that happens, then Orr goes up over the top. Thomas, the defensive tackle, tries to get there, but there's too much power. Now, just watching the line, and watch where the white shirts are. They're down, and when they get down, then Orr can go up over the top.
Well, Paul, we figured coming in this game, it's going to be decided in the trenches. And 14 points, of course, not that great a lead. The game's far from being over. We're too early. But the battle of the lines has already shown us that it's really happening there with authority for Texas.
And I just feel now that Auburn must get the ball, not only to Bo Jackson, but start to utilize Tommy Agee, number 30, their fullback.
Each time, Jeff Ward has refused to kick with the wind in his back, and he sails another one back there. Picked off here by Ed Graham. Graham comes over the 20. 25, he's filled up there at the 28-yard line. Number 21, Ed Graham. Well, we're delighted to be here, Texas, and we're delighted to be here in 1984 to bring you live football action from the College Football Association lineup. There's the score from Tennessee. Johnny Majors ball 7, Utah nothing. Tennessee expects to be a force in the Southeastern Conference. Auburn, of course, will be going back to conference battle. And there's Big Bertha, the world's biggest fan, 500 pounds. Auburn now with Pat Washington back for the wishbone. Gives it into the first man, Agee, the fullback. He is stacked up after a short game by Ralph Darnell and Tom Aldridge. Maybe a couple-yard pickup.
Here's the man that must take the pressure off Bo Jackson. That's Tommy Agee, number 30. And when he reads it, now he picked up only 2 yards on the play, but what it does, it makes the Texas defense start thinking a little bit now about Agee. Maybe take their mind off of Bo Jackson.
Coming down the end of the first quarter. Here's the pitch to Bo Jackson. Cuts through a hole, makes his way up over the 35. About 2 or 3 yards short of the first down. Mark Petkovic, a backup middle linebacker, spilled him there. Now we're going to come down the end of the quarter. 3 seconds, 2 seconds, 1 second. And that's the end of the first quarter. And Austin, with the score, Texas 14. And the Auburn Tigers nothing. Overhead, the Goodyear blimp here as the action comes to you from Austin, Texas. We're going to quarter number two, the Auburn Tigers. This will be an interesting third down play here. They've got third and about three. And now the wind at the back for Auburn. Auburn has yet to score a first down. Texas had five in the first quarter. There's the familiar wishbone of Pat Dye. Pitch to Bo Jackson. Jackson got the first down, breaks tackles, and drives up over the 40. It's the first down for Auburn. Mark Petkovich and Eric Jeffries with the men on the stop for Texas. But Hook's more important. It may get Auburn started. The wind's at their back. Texas took great advantage of the win in the first quarter. And now it's Auburn's turn. Look at this first quarter. That should tell you, look at Auburn. Minus yardage rushing and total yardage, 117-7.
Texas defense.
First down play, and here's Washington's play action, drills it, it's caught by Gaines. Jeffries hits him down, and he's across into Texas territory for the first time, and close to a first down. Trey Gaines, best hands on the team, number 19 right there for Auburn. Came out of a knee injury in the spring and has won the split-in position away from a couple of young players, Freddie Wagan and Clayton Buford. It is a first down for Auburn, their second in a row.
You know what's so bad about those first quarter stats, Jim, is that against Miami, the Auburn Tigers only had two players that graded out in the plus column.
Steve Wallace, the big left tackle, is one of them. Now they got the two young wide receivers in there. As the line going for the bomb, could be intercepted. Ray was back there, but couldn't quite reach it. Intended for Wagan, way overthrown, and Jerry Gray was there. And who will forget the overthrown pass Washington had that could have beat Miami?
Well, I don't even have any idea where Washington, unless he was throwing to a spot, and Wagan went the wrong way, because look at the ball is thrown to the outside. Gray, being the fine safety that he is, he played the ball. Wagan was 10 yards to the inside. Pat Dye saying to his assistants, who was he throwing that to?
Second down and 10, Auburn at the Texas 47. It's the first penetration of Texas territory. Fullback Age, he's got it. He breaks through there. Cracks down for a first down. Almost the 35-yard line. Penalty flag is dropped. Jerry Gray's the man who made the stop. He may be a face guard, and if so, it could be against Texas. And this could set Auburn up now for a scoring opportunity. Let's listen to the referee, Joe Thomas. Well, there's the signal at least. Face guard against Texas. That'll be an add-on penalty.
Incidental, which is five yards,
right?
And if they rip your face off, it's 15.
15 and a dozen roses.
Yeah, and half a new face.
31 yards.
Grasping a face mask, defense, 5 yards, first down.
And that sets Auburn up at the Texas 31. War Eagle getting ready to fly here, perhaps. Don't worry, she's anchored down. You can hear that cry, though, the Auburn fans that are in here. Texas brought its first line linebackers back in the game. Washington now. Counterplay to Bo Jackson. He almost broke it. Jackson to the 20-yard line. Middle linebacker Tony Edwards smelled that play just in time.
You talk about a counterplay, and you hit it right on the head, my friend. But just take a look at. Watch Bo Jackson. They're all going to go right. And watch Bo come back to the left. Just a great handoff. The block was made there on Tony. The great was blocked. And then downfield for the play goes Bo Jackson. He's about a half a yard short, about 9.5 yards.
Jackson goes out of the lineup. Tim Jesse comes in to replace him. Fullback is still AG, got second, about a yard to go. And they give it to AG for the first down. He's got it and more. AG follows his center, Yan Coward and Jeff Lott, for yardage for another first down. Ralph Darnell and Stephen Bragg with the ball in the stack for Texas. Another first down, and Auburn is rolling. It looks like the team that has the win is the one that moves.
Fred Akers a little concerned. He's got a 14-point lead. Let's get up in there. I'm going to tell you something. On that second down and short, where that half yard, Texas had all 11 men up on a line of scrimmage. Wagan was downfield. So was Buford. They were both downfield wide open. If they ever pull up and just hit that pop pass and waste it down, could have a touchdown.
First down play coming up for Washington. Auburn threatening. Here's the play action rollout. Didn't throw Texas. Into the end zone, incomplete. Trying to hit Wagan, the youngster. He was pretty well covered by Jeffries back in the corner of the end zone.
Well, we know that Washington has a strong arm. That time he was going to run a rollout, a bootleg play, and Texas read it very well. So he just sat up flat-footed and threw the ball clear across field. I mean, it was out of bounds.
That was Jim Moore, Paul, a journeyman senior left end. He got in there and stopped that bootleg from really developing. Second and 10 now for Auburn at the Texas 16. He gives it to Agee. Agee on a slap, breaks a tackle inside the 10-yard line, and down he goes. Jerry Gray, the All-American free safety, had to come in and finally take him down. Boy, he's a tough runner.
Yeah, but for you young high school players, you want to know how to run the fullback slot. Agee knows he's going to get hit every time he carries the ball. Watch his legs. I say this, and I'll say it in the game. Watch his legs. They never stop moving. His legs are churning. Watch this. He'll break back to the outside, breaks the tackle, then he moves back upfield and picks up about 7 yards.
And a pretty good stutter step mixed in there. Nice game. Third down and 3. Auburn's inside the Texas 10. Big play. Agee, they call his number again.
He's got it.
And he's got it inside the 5-yard line. First and goal for Auburn. Jerry Gray again makes the stop, but too late to save the first down for Auburn.
Cody, yesterday, Agee's going to make the difference in this ball game. Now watch this. He hits at the line of scrimmage. Look at his legs. The continuous effort of Agee never slows down. I don't like second effort. You know why? Because when people say second effort, it's like he quit the first time.
That's right. This continues first effort. Remember, he got over 90 yards against Michigan in the Sugar Bowl. Now Auburn trying to get 7 points back to 12, 14 nothing. They give it to Bo Jackson. He tries the left side, running right behind Big Steve Wallace. And he gets some precious yardage in there before Ralph Darnell and Tony Edwards can find him. It'll be second down and goal, and they'll have about 2.5 yards to go for pay dirt. Oh, Pat Dice getting a little sighted over the sidelines there. Remember, Auburn won the first SEC championship in 26 years under Pat. He's become very popular down there for a guy who used to be an assistant for Bear Bryant.
Now we have a timeout by Auburn.
And it comes with 11 minutes and 10 seconds to go in the first half. From Austin, Texas, the score, Texas 14, Auburn nothing.
Tired of faded.
The Memorial Stadium here on the campus of the University of Texas. And Pat Dial on the Auburn sidelines. A little more excited now. His team was trailed 14-0 going in this quarter, but now they're on the threshold of breaking in. Second and goal, about 2.5 yards. They come 70 yards on this drive. Here's the keeper, Washington. Pitches it out, and it's a touchdown by Collins. Kyle Collins, the left halfback. Great option pitch out on the fake by Washington. Drew in the Texas defense. Pretty play, Paul McGuire.
Oh, it was a pretty play. And Washington, he may not be able to complete passes downfield, but sideways he can throw the ball. There's your pal, the War Eagle. You want to see him jump on Bevo. Watch this. Now watch Washington. Watch him flip it. That ball goes out about 12 yards. Here comes Collins. Not a chance on the outside by Jerry Gray. Collins with a touchdown. That's perfect. Like I said, he can't throw him downfield, but sideways is beautiful.
So Auburn, with the wind at its back, has come back to get half the scores back. It's 14-6. Here's the try with the extra point. Drill right through there by Robert McGinney. And now it's suddenly back to a 7-point lead. The score, Texas 14 and Auburn 7. Bevo the 12th looking on here as his team leads by 7, facing a big fourth down play here by Auburn. Fourth about 2. Roll out by Washington. He's going to run for the first down. He's got it. Washington inside the 30. 25 for Pat Washington. A first down for Auburn. And a big fourth down call for Pat Dye.
First of all, you have to admire that man's guts for doing that. You're down 7 points. But the play that was called was absolutely spectacular. Watch the play of the offensive line. Here they come. They're coming out to the outside. Stokes and Lott blocking in front. There's Lott, 66. Stokes is 64. And all he's doing, Washington's no dummy. He just said, I'll get behind 66, Jeff Lott, and follow him.
Now Auburn's rolling again. First down at the Texas 25. They trail by just 7. Washington goes to sidelines. Incomplete, penalty down intended for Clayton Buford. Number 11. Covering over there was James Lott. But a flag goes down. I think Texas might have been offsides.
You're absolutely right. Texas offside. They'll take a 5-yard penalty here.
You know, this is the first half has been like two different halves. Texas dominated the first quarter.
The guard can't move.
Brady Akers letting him know the guard. He thought the offensive guard made a move. But you ever see a fellow think that his team made the mistake?
They don't see it that way. You know, this Texas team is so good on defense. They really are.
Offside. Defense.
They are a strong defensive team. Again, I say they use their kicking game better than I think any other college team in the country. And right now, the one man that they were afraid of was Bo Jackson, who is doing a job, but also A.G. is hurting it.
Fullwood and Jess here and there. Here's the pitch back to Fullwood. Fullwood tries to sweep to the right side, trying to cut inside in, moves it down close to the 15. Bill Hethcock, Texas, tripped him up. Now it's going to be very close to a first down. It was first and five after the penalty. Fullwood got the starting call tonight. The sophomore is a very exciting player. Isn't the blocker that Tim Jesse is, but he's got more explosiveness, and in broken field, he is something to watch. It'll be second and less than a yard here for Auburn. Maybe a chance for Washington to try to fake him and do something. Nope, he's going to try to get the first down. He does. That's Brett Fullwood cracking in behind Rondy Stokes and down to the 10-yard line for a first down for Auburn. June James on the stop, but Auburn's power now is coming to the fore for the Tigers.
All right, Tony DeGray, the man we're talking about. Now watch, they're going to double team him right here. There is the double team. Lott is blocking. Once you get Tony DeGray out of there, now all you have to worry about is the linebacker.
Another great block by Tommy Agee on that play, too. First and 10, ball just outside of 10. They could get a first down, I believe. Virtually first and goal. There's a mix-up, and Washington has to eat the ball at the line of scrimmage. Hethcock and Adams put the pressure on from tackle for Texas.
Actually, that ball popped up in the air, and it came right back down into Washington's hands. It was a fumble.
Bo Jackson's coming back on the field for Auburn. That always causes a little more excitement. Jackson, who's been a leading candidate for the Heisman Trophy since last year, led the Southeastern Conference rushing with over 1,200 yards in three other categories, has had a little trouble, has not been in contact practice since the Miami game because of an ankle injury. Tony DeGray has come back in for Texas. Second down and goal for Auburn. And they give it on the inside handoff, and DeGrade again stops that play. Handoff is for the fullback, Tommy Agee. James also knifed over from his linebacking post to help out. Texas defense really tightens up down here when you get near the goal line. They've always been noted for that. Auburn's got tremendous power with guys like number 30, Agee, and number 34, Bo Jackson. 14-7, Auburn trying to tie it up here. Third down and goal from the 9-yard line. Take a pass, Paul. They got Middleton out the right.
A
tight end.
A bootleg or a roll.
Gaines is split wide to left. It's a delay draw play to Fullwood, and he's hit around the 6-yard line. Brett Fullwood, a little draw play. Tony Edwards, the middle linebacker, saw the play, and he made the stop. McGinney there, and in comes number 13 for Auburn. That's McGinney, the kicker. And they'll try for the field goal, cutting the margin to 4 points if he can hit. It'll be a little bit of an angle from the right for the soccer-style kicker, and try at 22 yards. Mike Mann will hold at the 12-yard line.
Tough angle. This is a tough angle.
Wind at his back for McGinney. And the kick is up, and it is good. So McGinney's picked up three more for Auburn with 3 minutes and 33 seconds to go in the first half. It is now Texas 14 and Auburn 10.
Auburn 14-10, the Tigers cut into the Longhorn lead when Robert McGinney converted a 40-yard field goal as time expired in the first half. So with the Longhorns now leading the Tigers 14-13, we continue the game early in the third quarter here on ESPN Classic.
All right, here in Austin, Texas. Great shots here from a Goodyear blimp. 1-point lead by Texas. Texas now is going to get the ball for the first time in the second half. Longhorns just had a 5-yard penalty marked off of a chop block.
Jim, it's very, very interesting. Freddie Akers talking. He said, "No, wait a minute. My guys don't chop block." So he's talking over the official. But let me explain something. Here's what Auburn has. Auburn must stop Texas here. They've got to remember the first quarter. Texas got the ball in excellent field position on two bad punts and marched down and scored right away. Two touchdowns. All right. Here we'll pick up not only the Auburn defense, but also the Auburn offense. If they can hold Texas here and get the ball back in decent field position.
That wasn't too bad a punt that time. Puts Texas with the penalty back to the 25. And now in is Todd Dodge. Had a good first half. Two wide receivers out. And he gets the first man through. Jerome Josh, the fullback, tries to break one up the middle. And he gets a short gain. Maybe around the 28. Ben Thomas, all-star candidate at tackle for Auburn, makes the stop.
Gene Chilton, number 74. Gene, the cook machine. Take a look at Gene. Now, he's blocking on the nose tackle, Hallman. And he sees Hallman's taken out, so he just moves off on McCurdy, number 52, and just drives McCurdy downfield.
Well, you think he is an All-American timber. Gene Chilton. Now, here's a rollout by Dodge. Dodge fires it, and it is intercepted back here by Caesar, I believe. And a penalty flag goes down. Could be interference.
It'll be interference because Caesar went through the ball carrier, knocked the buck, or the pass receiver, knocked him down, and then caught the ball.
There goes William Harris, the tight end. It was on a crossing pattern. Caesar was treading him. There's the signal. It's against Auburn. Now watch Caesar.
All right, first here comes William Harris off the line. And the coverage is there. You see Carr, number 54, trying to get in front. Now watch what Caesar does. He goes through the man, bumps him right there. That's pass interference. Makes the catch.
Defense, decline, first down.
Wait a minute. You can't decline it. The defense caught the ball.
I don't understand that call.
95, he caught, I thought Caesar had the ball.
I
That's my
too.
Fault. Can you
bounce,
believe that? Harris bounce, caught the football.
Bounce right back to Harris. They take the play. And it's a gain up to the 42-yard line. Oh, they pick up, you know, pass interference. It would have gotten 15 yards on the play. They're going to take the pass play, which gives them about 12 or 13. It'll still be a first down for Texas on the 42-yard line. New rule this year. Used to, you got the penalty right in the spot of the foul. I think Texas might have got a little mixed up there. They could have had 15 yards in the line of scrimmage. Oh, I guess it is the spot of the foul or 15. Jerome Johnson heading straight ahead for Texas. Stacked up in the middle of the line. Greg Carr was in on that play. Great All-American linebacker for Auburn. As a good luck, Todd Dodge has shown himself well here. Had a back injury playing tennis over the summer. Had to recover from that. Proved that the old saying that he can't run is a little fiction. He ran it in for a touchdown back in the first quarter.
Now we saw some unbalanced line in the first quarter of the game. We have not seen it so far here in the second half.
Bill Boy Bryanson there is a double wide receiver. It's a deep hand off the tailback Robinson. And boy, is he cracked behind the line of scrimmage by Auburn. Auburn was really aroused that time. And they went in there to smack down Robinson. Harold Hallman and Ben Thomas just ran over people. Watch them to get to the ball carrier.
Is that Gerald Robinson, too, number 95, coming in there? It certainly is. Watch this. He hits a fullback, Johnson, and then also hits Robinson. And he had some help in the backfield by Hallman. That's just, they just went at the runners and forgot about anything, any kind of bootleg pass.
They lose back almost what they gained on the previous play. Third down and close to 10 yards to go. Terry Orr now goes in the backfield for Texas. Also in there is Keldon Nelson. Now is Freddie Akers shaking up his backfield lineup.
Delay a game.
And here's going to be a call against Texas. That'll cost them another 5 yards. That's a big third down play. And here they've had the wind at their back in the first 5 minutes of the second half, and Texas going to come up with a big play here to keep possession.
Dead ball, delay, offense, third down.
They have 25 seconds to snap the ball once it's put in play. At that time, Texas couldn't get it off in time. Oh, that's an even bigger third down play. Third and 14 back at the 37. Actually, they got to go almost 15 yards. Bill Boy Bryant comes out of there. Kevin Epps goes back in. Epps is the big home run player for Texas. He can fly. He's over the left side, top of your screen. Here he comes in motion. Play action. Pressure is put on him. Here's a pass. Drill down. He's caught down there by Nelson for a first down. Kevin Nelson came out of the backfield. And with the heat on Dodge, he stood in there coolly and drilled it for first down, a big play.
Gerald Robinson was about a half a step getting to Todd Dodge. You see 95. He just goes right by the offensive tackle, which is Greg Wright. Bang, there goes.
Ooh.
He'll take that if he gets the first down, which he did get. Here it comes. Watch his shot. Bang. Then Nelson, what the pass is. Nelson had the weight on it. But number four, Briggs, didn't play the back coming out of the backfield.
Now here's Dodge rolling again, drills it, and it's caught again around the 32-yard line. Another great completion for Texas. Nat sees it there coming. The tight end William Harris on a crossing pattern. And now Dodge is mixing up his receivers, and he is going to the air. And I think we're going to see a lot of passing coming up here. Dodge was shaken up. Rob Morshall has come on the field for Texas, but I think he's in as a running back. Reddy Akers talking with Dodge. Looked like Dodge shaken up a little bit on that last play, but he's going to stay in there.
He's got rib pads on, Todd Dodge has, but he was holding his ribs. That shot he took from Robinson, number 95, on the play before last, I think it hurt him.
First down play, Texas. Now the Auburn 32. Here's Dodge going for the deep and down the middle, and he's got a touchdown to Duhon. Deep post pattern to Brent Duhon, his first call tonight, and boy, did he make it count.
Brent Duhon did make it count, but you've got to give the credit to Todd Dodge. Where he put this ball, there was no chance for Caesar, number 49, to intercept the football. This was a perfect pass. Had that ball been just a little bit, look at Freddie Akers, he's smiling. If that would have been just a little bit off target, it might have been picked off.
And the try for the point now, Jeff Ward, he's hit 33 in a row. That's 34 out of 34, and the score now, Texas 21, Auburn 13.
Welcome back to Memorial Stadium, where the Texas Longhorns lead the Auburn Tigers 21-13 midway through the third quarter. Texas has regained possession after forcing an Auburn punt right here on ESPN Classic.
Some happy fans from the Lone Star State giving the old hook'em horn sign as the Longhorns lead 21-13. Big intersectional battle here against Auburn. Texas has been set further back in a hole. Penalty for clipping was tacked on the run back to back of the 13, first and 10. Johnson fullback, Morshall now the tailback. They give it to Rob Morshall. Tries to find a hole on the left side, nothing doing. Driven back by Greg Carr, Auburn's All-American lineback from Birmingham.
Morshall. He's all right. He's got a deep bruise in his back. But, you know, the reason that they moved Morshall, of course, they had a tailback problem. But as a quarterback, when he played, he ran so well with the ball. They figured, why not? Well, we'll use him at tailback.
Might mention that Edwin Simmons, who's being compared by many down here to Earl Campbell,
is
recovering. Boy, he is awesome looking. He's running now. Be back in a couple weeks, he thinks. There's a rollout by Dodge. Drills it downfield. Had a man open, threw it too short. Incomplete. Intended for Billboy Bryant at the 27-yard line. Ran a little hook pattern down there trying to get the first down. Good pressure by Ben McCurdy.
You see Todd Dodge there. He knew he had Billboy Bryant wide open. He just threw the ball into the dirt. Come back with it. Come on back with it. He said, can I do that one again? What do you think, Coach?
You know, Dodge had some bruised ribs, too, from practice earlier this year and had to fight right down to the wire to beat out Danny Akers and Brett Stafford and Rob Morshall for the starting quarterback spot. Morshall thought he had a good chance to get it. He started 9 games last year, but Dodge beat him out with his passing, so they moved Morshall to tailback, and that's where he is. And here he is, Morshall on the sweep. Left side with the power, it isn't there. Doesn't get enough of an escort, and he's taken down on the 17-yard line by Gerald Williams and John Daly. So Auburn brings up a punting situation for Texas. Now the Longhorns will be kicking with the wind. John Telchik comes in. He's an outstanding punter for Texas.
He can flat kick a ball about 70 yards, Telchik. He's got a great leg, barefoot kicker. Buford back there.
Gainers. Buford is also back for Auburn. Good snap for Telchik. And Telchik hits a beauty. Oh, boy, way back. Back is Gainers. Lets it go over his head. Hits to the 25-yard line. And it'll be down on the 26. Boy, that is some punt. He punted that ball about over 50 yards.
John Telchik, first-team All-American this year, maybe second-team last year. Here's a barefooted kicker. Now watch. You got to keep your toes down when you punt anyway, with or without the shoe. Now watch his toes. His head's down, and his toes going to be down. Drops the ball flat, and he flat hits it. Look at that leg extension. That's beautiful.
And there's the beautiful state capitol for the state of Texas here in Austin. Well, a magnificent structure. As you're watching action here, Auburn takes over first and 10 back at its own 27. Give it up again the middle to the fullback. Now the wishbone, Tommy Agee. Gets a very short game. Neither team has given up much up the middle tonight. Neither Texas nor Auburn. Both teams have had to go to the air to get anything substantial going or try to get outside. Bo Jackson so far has not been able to shake loose. But Jackson is playing with very little practice. He's had no contact because of a bad ankle since the Miami game. Washington off the side. The man didn't see it. Nobody was there. He was throwing in direction of Freddie Weygand, who's trying to block Eric Jeffries.
Weygand, it must have been a checkoff. Weygand, look at, you can see Pat Washington. He's looking at Weygand. Look at, when I call a pass pattern, I want you to run a pass pattern. I want you going downfield.
5 minutes, watch it again here.
Ty Allard, number 48. They're going to block him low. Forget that. And then Agee hits him high. He's there. He's in the face of Washington. But again, Washington threw the ball out here to Weygand, and Weygand was downfield blocking.
Now it's third down for Auburn back at their 28-yard line. They did a big play here. They'll be going against the wind. Sideline pattern is caught over there by Bo Jackson. Jackson, a dangerous man, comes over the 45, gets the first down before Jerry Gray can get to him. That time they used Jackson as another kind of a weapon.
I can see where Pat Washington is going to be a good quarterback, because watch, the pressure is on. He goes back to pass, no play action. Agee's back there blocking. But watch, he just sits flat-footed. He sees Bo Jackson on the outside. When you get this man the ball, look out. There are a lot of trouble. That's Bragg, number 6, in there making a tackle, along with number 2, Jerry Gray.
Well, it's a clutch first down for Auburn. They move it up to their 49, first and 10, trailing by 8 points. Washington fakes his fullback. Play action pass. Going for the home run. And down is Weygand. The Spitzer's got it inside the 10. First and goal for Auburn. Freddie Weygand, just a freshman from Gadsden, Alabama. But he used his speed to get in the open. And a beautifully thrown ball.
Freddie Weygand outruns this football. That's why he makes the catch. Now watch. Washington played everything he had into the ball. It's against the wind. But watch Weygand. He gets in a tough catch over the shoulder. He had to make the catch. It was just beautiful. Tony Griffin, number 16, trying to stay with him. Again, Weygand ran after the ball and caught up with the football.
All right, it's Agee College of Jackson now in the wishbone. Auburn will try to punch it in here and get back. 2-point point if they score will get them even. Here goes Bo Jackson, touchdown. Bo Jackson, there's the artistry of the master, Heisman Trophy candidate. Once he smells pay dirt, great block by Steve Wallace, open the hole, and he plunges in. And now Auburn has a chance with a 2-pointer to pull even.
All right, you see Bo Jackson running, but now let's take a look at some of the blocking in there. There's Collins, and there's also Agee. They get the blocks down up in the line of scrimmage, and you get Bo Jackson at hole. Goodbye. That was Tony Edwards, the middle linebacker, number 63, making a tackle, but that was 8 yards deep.
Auburn likes to get 3 wide receivers in here and then roll out with a little action here to try and go for 2 points. Obviously, they're going to try that here. They need 2 to tie the game. It's 21-19 Texas. Boy, talk about action in September. Well, this is like a championship game. There are the 3 wide receivers to the right. Washington coming back up the middle of fullback Agee. Cannot make it. Texas stopped him short. And Texas will retain the lead. It is Texas 21 and Auburn 19. And we'll be right back.
We pick up the action early in the fourth quarter with Texas leading Auburn 21-19. A Longhorn punt has given the ball back to Auburn on their own 20-yard line here on ESPN Classic.
Boy, what a beautiful sight we have here in Austin, Texas. Texas fans moving up for the Longhorns. Auburn fans have come up here, not as in big numbers, but they feel now their team has got some momentum going in the fourth quarter. Here's the cow fumble. Texas has got it at the 16-yard line. Brett Fullwood fumbled, and Jim Moore, number 75, pounced on it for the Longhorns. Tremendous break. Only the second turnover of the game, the first one in favor of Texas.
Oh, it's beautiful. Texas waiting. They're a patient team. They play strong defense, and they wait for the breaks. Breaks give them the game. But on this play, Fullwood, I don't know if he's supposed to get the ball or not, because Pat Washington, is he going to go down the line? because look at the ball is gone. Fullwood, yeah, the way Washington looked, I think maybe he was supposed to give the ball to Fullwood. Fullwood didn't take it.
Paul, I think it's the same counterplay Bo Jackson ran for the big game.
You're right.
Now a big break for Texas. Let's see if they can cash in. First and 10 at the Auburn 17-yard line. Dodge pitches it back. Here's Nelson on a sweep. Cuts inside. Goes to the 10-yard line. Kevin Nelson, a freshman, exciting open field runner. All the way down to the 10. Ben McCurdy, great block by William Harris, swung him loose. McCurdy finally hauled him down. It's a pickup on the play at 7 yards, second down and 3. Big break for Freddie Akers' team. Their lead was down to 2 points, and they have the handicap of the win here in the fourth quarter. Nothing bounces crazy like a football, though, and the Longhorns are passed on the fumble. Second and 3, they give it to fullback. There goes Johnson. Johnson will score. Touchdown. Might have been a little short trap or just a quick hitter, but Jerome Johnson found the hole, Paul McGuire.
Yes, he did, and Jerome Johnson was supposed to carry that ball between the tackle and the end. It was a little dive play, but what he did when he got to the line of scrimmage, he was hit, and he saw that opening back to his right, so he just broke it back to the inside. A beautiful play by Texas.
Now Jeff Ward comes in. He'll be trying for his fourth point tonight. He's hit 34 in a row. Hasn't missed yet, and there's another one. There goes Smokey the Cannon. 28-19, Texas in the lead.
Now what's the action? The action is to the right of the screen. See, it's supposed to be blocked this way to the inside. Well, Gene Chilton, number 74, the center, got a tremendous block, and when Johnson saw that hole break back to his right, he just cut it back for the touchdown.
Jerome Johnson didn't get his starting call until the last minute. The score now, Texas 28, Auburn 19.
It happens.
19. Texas foul goes to the defense. Auburn with a wishbone attack. Takes the fullback. Washington on the play action. Washington sack. Hits from the blind side. Ball gets loose. Texas may have recovered it. Let's see. They do. Texas recovers a fumble. James McKinney was the man who hit Washington the blind side. And Texas comes up with its second big turnover here in the second half.
Texas is fired up. They know Auburn's going to pass the football with 7:25 to play. They knew they had them, and they just teed off that defensive line. Watch Washington now. He sets up about 4 or 5 yards. He's got good blocking right here, but all of a sudden he's going to get hit. Was that Bronner hit him from the back?
McKinney, I believe, yep.
Number 87, McGinney comes up with the ball. Excuse me, it wasn't him. It was number 62, James, the linebacker. June James.
He got the ball, and so now it's Texas, first and 10 at the Auburn 45. 7 minutes, 25 seconds to go. Let's see if Texas tries to keep it on the ground here and grind out the clock. Running in the eye, they give it to the fullback, hitting straight ahead. Johnson gets a little room and spins over the 40, and then he's just about beheaded down there by Arthur Johnson, who spun him all the way around with a really banging hit. 6 yard pickup. Nevertheless, it'll be second and 4. And the clock ticking on down here with 7 minutes, 2 seconds to go in the game. Texas up by 9. Longhorns are very tough at home. They've lost 9 times in 91 years in their opening game. Freddie Akers never lost a home opener.
Well, I think the one thing we set up at the beginning of the game, Jim, is the fact that Texas had to pass in order to win the football game. And that pass to Brent Duhon.
Pitch back to Orr. Here's Orr in the sweep. Orr fighting, got a first down. He's inside the 30. Now Texas going to its running game, and they're making it work. Kevin Green, a walk-on. You know, it's just been a brilliantly called game by Akers and Dodge.
Oh, exactly. Take a look at Orr's out front. And there's a missed tackle in the backfield by Johnson, number 40. And Orr keeps his feet, picks up the first down. Texas on a drive, and with their field goal kicker, Jeff Ward, they can put this thing away.
Texas, they got tough games coming up with Penn State, later Oklahoma, and then, of course, the Southwest Conference race. Looks like it's going to be a little wide open. Pitches back to Orr again on the sweep. Keeps the ball inbounds. Keeps the clock rolling. Stopped by McCurdy, short of the 25-yard line. Second down coming up, maybe about 6 or 7 to go. or becoming the workhorse down here for Texas. He was one of the all-time great high school stars in this state, which really prides itself on producing football players. There's the time story, the score. The happy Horn fans. And they lead it by nine. And Fred Akers, who's trying to chalk up victory number 77, to start his 11th year. They give it the first man through the fullback, Johnson. Got some room. 15. Johnson's got a first down inside the 15-yard line. Arthur Johnson makes the stop for Auburn, but Jerome Johnson was the man there. Remember the touchdown he scored in the third, fourth period here that sprang Texas into a big lead.
Texas had not been able to run the ball up the middle for most of the game, for three and a half quarters. All of a sudden, they ran a couple of sweeps to the outside, which opened up the middle. That's Carr, number 54, missing the tackle. And Jerome Johnson picks up another first down inside the 15, almost to the 13-yard line. But when you start running things wide, and they get their tendencies on a defense to go wide with it, that middle opens up.
You know, Paul, this Texas team backfield was really in a shambles. And it shows you the great depth they have here. They lost Edwin Simmons, their great tailback. They had to move a quarterback to tailback. He got hurt. Then they moved the fullback over there. They started with two fullbacks. And yet here they are, poised perhaps to spring a big victory over Auburn. Still a lot of time to go, 5 minutes. But a 28-19 lead looks pretty good right now as they drive in for another possible score. And coming up after the game, the Chevrolet College Football Report, right after the game with all the scores and highlights around the country.
I'm trying to sit over here and call the thing to let it run down. You give me this press. Anytime you do that, you check that clock.
Brady Akers making a very pointed remark there. Point that you need to get that ball snapped within 25 seconds. Now look at him the way he pats Dodge on the back. Yeah, well, he can make Dodge too mad here. He's done a great game, Paul.
Well, Todd Dodge, what happened is the play that was called, he didn't think that the formation, I would imagine, didn't think that the formation was right for it. So you wonder why you would take a timeout in the fourth quarter with the clock running and only 5 minutes to go, and you're up by nine. But actually, Todd Dodge did the smart thing. Instead of running a play that maybe they don't have the formation for or don't have the right personnel in there for, he's going to check. They're in command of the game.
All right, Hayes to left, Bill Borthwine to the right. They give it to the fullback up the middle, and Jerome Johnson. Now here they come around the other way, and there's Johnson still on his feet, scores.
Oh, do you love it? Don't you love it?
He just refused to go down. Jerome Johnson couldn't find anything in the middle, and he just reversed his field. And that's to be the one that spelled doom for Auburn.
There was absolutely no place for Jerome Johnson to go. Watch the middle. Holman's in the middle. Take a look at it. The middle is sealed off. He is hit at the line of scrimmage by Gerald Williams. And watch, he'll break it back to the outside. And just watch the determination. Moves the ball into the right hand. Get it outside where they can't get a shot at it. And then breaks it back in for the touchdown. That's just a great run.
He took on seven Auburn players right there and still got it in the end zone. Texas may have put it out of reach with that. 34-19. Jeff Ward in to try for the point after. He's got it. That's 36 in a row for Ward and the point after department. And Texas has taken a commanding lead.
All right, take a look at it right here. Bang, he hits in the middle. There's no place to go. Now he's going to come back to the outside. Gerald Robinson can't get him. He gets a screen off block. Even though Todd Dodge didn't make a block, he screened off the defensive end, Robinson. And then Johnson on his own, literally on his own. Watch the reaction here at the bench. That's right. I called that play. I'll take credit for that one.
Well, Fred Akers has to be happy because he didn't name Jerome Johnson a starter until this morning. He had planned to use Terry Orr at fullback after Ronnie Robinson was moved from fullback to tailback. So Johnson's come from third string. To start this game, he scored two touchdowns, has a total of 58 yards. And boy, he'll remember this night for a long, long time. And remember, Johnson, the senior, has had to fight a lot of injuries here at Texas. It looks like he could have an outstanding 84. Another bounding kick downfield. And another fumble here by Auburn, and they're going to drop on it around the 23-yard line. Collis Campbell just couldn't find a handle. Tim Jesse came over to help him. And by that time, Johnson was downfield for Texas, and he had to just drop on the ball and kill it at the 23.
You know, Jim, if you look at Texas and you watch the way they play football, this is a typical Texas game. They do the things that they have to do to win. Special teams, their kicking game, and their defense. And when the defense gives you the ball that many times, something has to break because they have the talent. And one other thing, Auburn, you can't make the mistakes that they made and win football games.
Auburn's got to take it to the air now. Here comes a pass thrown on the ground by Washington. He tried to hit Clayton Buford. Incomplete pass. James Lott covering. Auburn's had its problems in this ball game. They've given up the football a lot. Look at those miscues. Fumble resulting in a touchdown. They coughed the ball up again right here, and Texas has taken it in to score. They had some other miscues that may not show in that, but down there when they were about to score, the fumble and then the backfield in motion cost him a touchdown. May have taken him out of the game. We'll see. Here's Washington. He's dangerous. Off the flat, little screen to A.G. 30. First down, A.G. 35. Taken out of bounds. Stops the clock with 4:34 to go.
The two other things you throw in there, and that, those were the first two punts by Lewis Colbert. One was 25 yards. Gave Texas the ball about the 40 or 45-yard line. They marched and scored. Second, the other thing was a 17-yard punt.
Well, down here, the action's great. How's it look up there, fellows? Up there, of course, is the Goodyear blimp with Captain Pilot Jim Dexter from Baltimore, Maryland, and the Goodyear blimp America from Houston, Texas, giving us some outstanding shots here in the evening, the Texas evening. Left side, Washington hits his man, Buford, over there, tried to get a little stutter step, but Tony Griffin refused to be taken out of the play. They may give Auburn some of these little short passes, but they're not going to let them break anything long if they possibly can help it. Right now, the clock's on the side. Now, remember, Auburn could tie this game with two touchdowns and a couple of two-point conversions.
They're going with the hurry-up offense, spreading everybody out. Texas got too many men on the field.
I look for Washington. There goes the penalty down. The free play here for Auburn. Thrown incomplete, intended for Kyle Collins. But I don't think Chris Delaband got off the field in time for Texas. They have 12 men out there, as Paul alertly noticed. Way to go, Paul.
Well, they're trying to go to their nickel defense, so they had to get some linebackers off and some defensive backs on the field. And I guess this is one that everybody talks about. There's Jerry Gray. He's talking to the officials, saying, well, what do we do wrong here? Well, with one thing you did wrong, you had 12 people on the field. But, when you go to the prevent defense, and it's legitimate. They got a 16-point lead, but two touchdowns and two two-point plays tie the score. But if you can stop them all night long, why let them have it and move down the field with 4.5 minutes to go?
That's a good point. It's been an argument over the years among fans who follow football. Should you go to prevent defense when your good defense is working?
Substitution infraction. Defense. First and five.
First down and five for Auburn now. The ball's at the Texas 41. Washington's got two wide receivers to the right and one to the left. Washington throws underneath here, and he hits his man, Collins, short of the 35. May or may not be a first down. Delaband made the stop.
They're going to measure this thing. It's got to get right at the 36-yard line, but I think they're beyond it. I honestly think it's a first down.
Well, they're going to ask for the chains to come across.
They'll get it by the nose of the ball. But they should. What they should do now, as soon as those chains get by, get your play called and get up on the line of scrimmage.
We'll be picking the Chevrolet players of the game immediately following the game, one from each team. Had a lot of standouts here on both sides of the ball tonight for both teams. Certainly for Texas, you've got to be thinking about their quarterback. Todd Dodge had a great night throwing.
And there's a new wide receiver in the game. Donaldson, number 29, is a split end for Auburn.
He's just a freshman. Duke Donaldson. I know Pat Dye wanted to redshirt some of these young guys, but he has to get them in there. Now other scores. Ole Miss, Arkansas still tied. They're in the fourth quarter. 14 all. Arizona leads Oregon 20-8 in the second quarter. And here we are, Texas holding on to a 35-19 lead over Auburn. Auburn hoping somehow to score two touchdowns here in the final 4 minutes and salvage a tie if they can. Down the middle. Almost intercepted by Gray. Oh, there's the All-American. craftily waiting in the wings, waiting for his chance, almost picked that one off.
Well, Washington tried to hit the ball to Tim Jesse, number 25, going down the middle of the back, coming out of the backfield. But Jerry Gray, the All-American, he was just sitting in there waiting. Watch it. You'll see it open up. See Jesse going down. Look at number two. Jerry Gray right there. The ball hit him right in the gut, but he was bumped by Jesse.
You know, Texas is one of the few college teams, Paul, that still plays a lot of man-to-man defense on passes. They use very little zone. Draw a play. Down the middle, Campbell. And Collis Campbell trying to pick up a first down here, trying to fool Texas looking for the pass. Ty Allard, the linebacker, stopped him short of the first down marker. They'll put it at the 30, and it'll be third down and four.
Just trying to do something to slow that defensive line down, because they're not even thinking about run. They're just coming. All four guys are just teeing off, but the lineman is going.
Four-man rush. Again, the ball is dropped, incomplete. Clayton Buford couldn't hold it. That ball was really drilled by Washington. It was thrown just a little bit low. Eric Jeffries was there anyway. And it brings up fourth down for Auburn. 3:35. You can pretty safely say this is the last chance here for Auburn. They have any hopes at all. They're trying to pick up 16 points in the last 3.5 minutes. They're going to have to pick up 4 yards here and keep this alive. You know, once Texas gets the ball, they're going to run out the clock as much as they can. Buford is to the right. Wagan is to the left. They run the draw play with Campbell, and he's got the first down. All the way to the 20-yard line, Eric Jeffries. And the fourth period, of course, moving the first down chain stops the clock with 3:29 to go. And you can bet Auburn will be ready to go when that ball's put back in play.
That time, Jim, they caught Texas in a blitz and ran a draw. It's an excellent call against that, except the clock keeps moving.
There's Washington going upstairs again. Right side, he's got Buford. Down around the 10-yard line, he's smacked down immediately by Tony Tillman. Tillman, a speedster, runs the 10-200. Ball's inside the 10, so it's going to be first and goal for Auburn. They got to score quickly and then get a successful onside kick. Three wide receivers to the left. Washington throws it out the left side, completes it over to Jesse. Jesse's taken out of bounds, short of the goal line. About the two by Jerry Gray, the All-American for Texas.
Jesse didn't get out of bounds. His knee went down inbounds, so the clock's still moving. Now we're inside of 3 minutes. It's amazing when the clock stops after every first down in college football, how many plays you can run in a short period of time.
Well, the old two-minute drill has become a factor. Now here's Auburn and the straight wishbone. They try to punch it over, and they give it to Collins, and Collins is stopped short, I believe, over there. Yep, didn't get it across. June James, weak side linebacker, Jerry Gray. That keeps the clock rolling. Auburn's going to have to spend a timeout here with 2 minutes and 36 seconds to go.
Well, this is where Collins has got to learn one thing. Once you get near that goal line, just push the ball out over the goal line. Watch how close Collins gets. He gets the blocks on the outside and moves back inside. He's got the ball in the left hand. Now, all he has to do is just stretch the ball out over the goal line. Yeah. Had he done that, but who's there?
I think he tried to do that, and Jerry Gray, the Texas All-American, got his helmet right on the ball and prevented it. Pretty smart play.
It was Jerry Gray. Again, we knew one thing. If you're going to run at Texas with all their great defensive players, the one man, if you want to make the big play and score, you've got to put Jerry Gray, number two, on the ground. Remember, he's the guy that caught Bo Jackson. He's the man that almost made the interception just a moment ago. The man that makes a stop on Jeffries, or on Jesse at the goal line.
Well, Paul, there's nobody here that doesn't realize what Auburn has to do. They have to score here and then try to get an onside kick and make the two-point extra point. They give it over the left side, and there's the touchdown over the middle. Brent, though, full wood goes. And Auburn has come back to score, so they keep some faint hopes alive here. 35 to 25.
Fullwood is airborne. Watch this. Plants his feet up over the top. He cleared everyone.
Right into glory land goes Fullwood for the touchdown for Auburn. You got to hand it to the Tigers. They're not going to give up. They're scratching and clawing. Pat Dye said, you'll see our best effort tonight. May not be enough to win, but it'll be our best. It won't be like it was against Miami. That was his comment. Going for the 2 points. They have to have this to have any chance to tie. Three wide receivers to the right, and they give it up the middle, and a penalty flag goes down. I think Texas might have stopped him anyway.
Texas offside.
Texas was offside. They got another chance. DeGrate was in there on the play. That's the second time they've done that. Fake the pass to White. Send the fullback, Agee, to the left. And Texas was offsides on the play. Auburn gets another chance on a half the distance penalty. This will be from the one. Makes it a little easier. The time is 2 minutes and 33 seconds.
Offside, defense, half the distance, replay the down.
Everything's got to happen just right for Auburn. They got to make these 2 points and get the football back and hope they can make eight more. A tie is the only thing they can do. Here's a keep, and Washington scores. They got the 2 points here. They're within eight. It's 35-27 with 2 minutes and 33 seconds to go. Jerry Gray did it. So there's the score now. Texas 35, Auburn 27. 35-27. Texas gave Auburn a second chance, and they made it pay. And now here comes the onside kick attempt. There's the ball. Got to go 10 yards, remember. Doesn't go 10 yards. And it's going to be... Auburn recovered, they didn't go 10.
You know why? Because if Texas doesn't touch the, if they don't touch the ball,
Texas player touched it.
Then Auburn can't fall on it. But once Texas touches the ball, it's a free ball. It becomes Auburn's ball. We have 48 kicking off, and we don't. I'm sorry, folks. We just don't have a 48 on our list.
Russell Hayes was in there, tried to recover it for Mike Hayes for Auburn. He got the ball, but obviously it touched a Texas player. The referee has signaled Auburn's ball. Auburn still got a chance here to pull out a tie. They'll have the ball at their own 44-yard. The ball went only 4 yards.
How about, is that a strange onside kick? Number one, Caesar is the up man. It stands on the ball. Then he takes the ball off the tee, moves the tee, sets the ball down. They all bunch, just roll it along the ground. If they leave the ball alone, Auburn would have touched the ball and never been able to recover the fumble.
Texas should have stayed back at the 50-yard line, but that's all hindsight. Remember, these young guys are anxious. Auburn now is going to be going in the air with 2 minutes and 32 seconds to go. Boy, talk about a thrilling, exciting windup here to this one. Both these teams came in here to put everything on the line. Here's Akers now getting the explanation from referee Joe Thomas. I don't think we're going to be able to hear it. But that's what happened. Onside kick rolling upfield. A Texas player anxious to get to the ball. Touched it before it gone the 10 yards and couldn't hold it. And Auburn recovered. Auburn still got a chance to get a tie.
What Fred Akers is talking about is that maybe one of the Auburn players kicked the ball along the ground after the ball had been kicked.
You suppose?
Well, now, if Auburn would have touched the ball first, then Texas got the ball and fumbled the ball, it would have still been Texas' ball.
That's right, because they've been illegally touched by Auburn before it traveled the necessary 10 yards. A free ball after it goes 10 yards, or if the receiving team touches the ball, it's a free ball. Otherwise, it isn't. So it's all up to Pat Washington now, number 10. They're coming down the end of the game. Auburn won lost a heartbreaker to Miami by 2 points, 20-18. They're down by eight. Looked like they were completely out of this game. They trailed 35-19. They picked up 8 points on the touchdown. So let's remind you that this is just part of what we're going to have here in September. Coming up next week, more excitement. Boston College, led by All-American Doug Flutie, one of the nation's most exciting quarterbacks. He'll have Scott Gieselman in there as a wide receiver. Now, powerful offense for Boston College against North Carolina that showed a lot of offensive punch today. They have Ethan Horton, a great tailback, who's a converted quarterback out of high school. Gained almost 100 yards and scored a touchdown today against Navy. So that'll be quite a confrontation on ESPN 1 week from tonight from Boston. First and 10 for Auburn. They're 54 yards away from getting a tie with plenty of time. 2.5 minutes to go. Here's an option keep by Washington, and he's going to be cut down around the 50-yard line. That keeps the clock rolling. Ralph Darnell made the stop. There's the time remaining now, a little over 2 minutes. Texas looking for Auburn to go to the air. They got their All-American number two, Tony Gray, back in a single safety. They got to beat him in the end. Here's the long pass. There goes Gray. He's got it. Picked off by Gray of Texas. That'll end it for the Longhorns. Intercepts on the 20-yard line, intended for Clayton Buford. And that's when the All-Americans come through when the chips are down.
There's a pure free safety here at Texas because they do play man-to-man, and they tell everybody, we're going to line up and play you man-to-man. And even when they get in their pre-vet defense, watch Tony Gray, or excuse me, Jerry Gray, number two. He's just playing the ball. He sees the throw. Pat Washington, the inexperience shows that he did not read the safety, man. If you're going to throw the ball against Texas in the prevent defense, you don't want to throw it in the middle of the field where that man is going to be.
All right, Texas now takes over 22. They'll try to run out the clock. They've got 2 minutes to kill here. So there's Gray. Gray had a great clutch reception, interception last year against Auburn. He comes up one here, killing Auburn's last slim hope. Been a long shot anyway for Auburn. They hand it off up the middle to Moorshell. Terry Orr hits into the middle. John Daly spills him up, and Texas isn't concerned about gaining much yardage. They want to run out the clock. Minute 49 to go. Orr getting up slowly. So it would seem this would dash the dreams here of the Auburn Tigers. Auburn calls timeout. It's the last time they can stop the clock. Next week again, we'll remind you, North Carolina versus Boston College. Doug Flutie going back to the air again after 2 weeks rest. That'll be in Foxborough, 7:30 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. Jim Sipps will be there, Paul McGuire. 2 weeks from tonight, Navy and their Heisman Trophy candidate, Napoleon McCallum. Had a great day today, over 100 yards against North Carolina Chapel Hill. Navy will go to Arkansas, and that'll be in Little Rock. So Arkansas having a battle tonight with Ole Miss. So every Saturday night, 7:30 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, it is College Football Association action here on ESPN.
Jim, did you believe that not only Auburn, 0-2, picked by many, including myself, was number one team in the nation,
and Alabama,
and Alabama 0-2.
They say it's never happened before. Now Fred Akers has sent the word in. All right, these coaches have worked the sidelines hard tonight. Remember,
74 power. They're going to run into four hole, which is on the right-hand side between the tackles.
Orr's the tailback.
And there it is.
There's Orr. Just ducks in there, picks up a yard or so. Clock rolling on, the minute 40 seconds to go. Harold Hallman, Gerald Williams. Conceivable here that Auburn could get the football back with not much time left.
Well, they'll get it with about 50 seconds after the punt. Well, it depends on what, if Auburn, do they have another timeout? I don't think they do.
I think Auburn's used up their allotment. Now we're down a minute 15, and Texas got 7 seconds here to snap the ball. Down to 2 seconds. Now they get the snap away and hand it off to the short man, the fullback Johnson. And Johnson is dumped in the backfield for a loss by John Daly. The clock now has moved down to the one-minute mark, and we're going to seconds now, 57 seconds to go. Texas will have to punt.
Here's where you just sit on it, Jim, and just take the five-yard penalty. It's not going to make any difference.
Now, Auburn will have 30 seconds when they get back the ball. And their only hope, it would seem here, Paul, would be to block this punt. 39, 38 seconds to go. Texas is going to run down. They've got 5 seconds. They're going to stay right back in the huddle here and take this five-yard penalty. And there it is, exactly 30 seconds to go in the game. Texas will take the penalty. And now Telchik will try to kick it out of there. And Auburn's hopes now would rest on a punt return touchdown or possibly blocking the punt. Otherwise, they're going to have to go a long way in a very short time.
Well, you go after it for the simple reason that he's kicking. Telchik is going to kick into the wind, number one, so he's not going to get a great kick out of it.
10-man rush.
Oh, yeah, they're all coming.
10 men are up there. Telchik knows they're coming at him. Now they're going to drop back for return. Here's Telchik. Trying to kick. They got a return set up here. Back over the 40, 35, 36-yard line. And Auburn will have a couple of shots at it here with 19 seconds to go as Gainis was stopped on the 36. We'll remind you again, ESPN will be bringing you the Chevrolet Players of the Game. This is a program, a Chevrolet Scholarship Program. $1,000 going to the Players College's General Scholarship Fund. Washington Washington downfield, incomplete. He was trying to hit over there to Wagan. Wagan was too late in duck covering, or he threw it too soon, one or the other.
He threw the ball out of bounds because he didn't have the time. Washington, again, the defensive line of Texas, they're just teeing off. Tony DeGrate, this is the kind of football that he loves, number 99, the All-American tackle. He's just going to tee off and go.
Remember this, in the old days, you throw the Hail Mary to the goal line and hope for interference. And under the new rules this year, to get an interference down there, it's only a 15-yard penalty.
That's right.
36 yards to go for Auburn.
That took 4 seconds.
Yep. You have 19 seconds left.
That's 14 seconds, I think, the way they
have it. Yep, it is 14. They give it on a draw play. Here comes fullback Agee, and they keep him in bounds at the 29-yard line. Texas spelling victory now, James Watt, and that will be the final play of the game, and Texas is the winner. In a high-scoring affair between two defensive teams, Texas comes out on top by 8 points, 35-27, in a game that featured the passing of Todd Dodge.
Yes, it did. Todd Dodge, I thought, had a sensational game, and I think this man right here, Fred Aker, called a sensational ball game for his team. They did what they had to do offensively, and that's throw the football.
Now they overcame the injuries and they won the final, Texas 35, Auburn 27.